for me, it's a very special facility, and for various reasons. First, I always say that the past is something you learn from. The future is something you look for. This facility, for me, represents both. The past, primarily, is the name of this facility. A man by the name of Charlie Atkeison. He's a man that I worked with for many, many years. He's also a very, very close friend. He represents to me something that I wish we all could do. He had a work spirit, a work ethic, an innovative attitude. If we all had it, of course we would be much further than we are today. But that's what I mean by the past, something we all can learn from. The future, of course, is this facility. Also, there are two people in the world that I have great respect for, of whom I learned from. Again, one is Charlie Atkeison, and the second one was my father. And I would like to dedicate this facility, the name of this facility, to Charlie Atkeison, and officially being named as the C. Atkeison Research and Pilot Line.
Service manager in 1975. At that time, Gall was selling a lot of woodyard systems that involved a lot of hydraulic drives, and we needed someone just to take charge of field service of all that equipment. We ran an ad, and Charlie applied for it, joined the company. He didn't know anything about hydraulics, so we sent him to hydraulic school, and he became an expert technician. Very quickly, and that's the kind of a guy Charlie was. Time went on, he worked on our woodyard equipment for 1 or 2 years, and then one day it just happened that both Tom Gall and I were out of the country, and we got a call from International Paper in Georgetown saying that they were having severe screening problems. Could they get someone there to work on their screens with them? This was their Cowan screen. And there was no one around, and Charlie said, "Well, I don't know how much help I can be to you, but I'll be glad to try." And so Charlie headed on over to Georgetown. Now, at that point in time, Charlie had never seen a screen, from the inside anyway. And so Charlie grabbed a couple of books that we had on screening files, articles we'd collected over time and so on, and he read these on the plane going over to Georgetown. That was on a Friday. I got back I was living in North Carolina. I got back on Sunday, and Sunday night I got a call from Tom Gall's secretary telling me about this emergency at Georgetown. So very first thing Monday morning, I called Georgetown and I said, look, I'm getting in the car, I'm coming your way right now, I'll be there this afternoon. And I was told, now look, we're out of trouble now, everything's going fine, there's no hurry. So I said, well, in that case, if you don't mind, there's a couple of calls I need to make on the way. I'll be down there about Wednesday or Thursday. That's perfect, they said. So I got in there on Thursday morning, and the pulp mill superintendent got me into his office, and he said, Art, I just want to tell you how good it was to get someone in here that really knew about screening. And that's the kind of a guy Charlie is. That was the start of what became Charlie's career love, which was the field of pulp screening. He went on to provide service to many of our customers. There wasn't a single one that when he was done that they didn't offer him a job in the mill. And that was our biggest worry, was that Charlie was going to go to a mill. After a few months later, he came to me one day. Now, back in those days, Gall used to print up a little newsletter that would be mailed out to the industry, and it was just kind of a helpful hints sort of newsletter. letter talking about our products and new applications and things like that. And Charlie came to me one day and he said, Art, I wrote up this little write-up on some of my thoughts on screening, and I thought you might want to read it. And you know how humble Charlie, but you know, maybe this is something you might like to consider for your newsletter or something like that. Well, I read the article and I said, wow, this is much too good an article for our newsletter. And so I approached John Evans, who was editor of Pulp and Paper magazine at the time, and I said, John, have a look at this and see if this is something you guys would be interested in. And the next morning he came back to me and he said, Art, he says, if you don't have any other commitments for this, he says, I insist on letting us publish this. And so that article went into print, which you see here, and became one of the best read articles in the industry. Over the years since, we have mailed out thousands of these reprints to people that simply wanted to have this information to train their operators and so on. We frequently got requests for 30 or 40 copies of this so they could bind it into all their operator training manuals and so on. And again, that's the kind of a guy Charlie was. As we got our own manufacturing going, eventually brought our own screen to the market, which is the Paraflow screen, which Celleco works with us on. Charlie was very instrumental in the design and development of that piece of equipment. Eventually, Charlie did leave Gall and went to join Georgia Pacific in what's now Georgia Pacific in Ashdown, Arkansas. And it wasn't long before we got a phone call from Charlie. You know that prototype rotor that we built to prove out the Paraflow concept? I need to stick that in one of our screens up here. So that became our second installation of a Paraflow screen. So Charlie's love of the screening field just stayed with him throughout. Finally, Charlie then joined Celleco, and when Gall and Celleco got together in 1989, then that gave Charlie the opportunity to get back into his career love. And he worked with us on screening right through to the very end. When Roland announced that this pilot plant would be named the Charlie Atkeison Research Center in his honor, we discussed this down at Gall, and it was with really great warmth and enthusiasm that we wanted to share in this occasion. So we decided that one of the best ways we could do that was to maybe develop a plaque that could be presented in Charlie's memory. Back, so I'll just read this plaque. Charles A. Atkeison III was employed as technical director by Celleco from August 1981 until his passing in June 28, 1993. Fondly remembered throughout much of the North American pulp and paper industry as Celleco Charlie, he exemplified a spirit of initiation and dedication rarely found in today's workplace. He was instrumental in the innovation and development of many Celleco products and product features. From 1975 through 1980, Charlie was employed at Gall Equipment Company, Theodore, Alabama, as a technical specialist, particularly in the field of pulp screening. The assimilation of the Gall Paraflow screen and related products into the Celleco product line in 1989 enabled him to continue this particular field of study and insight. In recognition of his years of ingenuity and devotion, this facility is named in his honor. Now we've got one other little presentation to make here. And let me start this part of it's going to be in two pieces. Let me start by telling you that, as you guys know, whenever I get involved with somebody, it's usually a story. So let me tell you another story. We had an artist do this rendition of Charlie in Mobile. Mobile. Her name is Anita Westerberg. She's a rising star on the Mobile artistic scene. She has recently won some awards from the Mobile Chamber of Commerce for artwork related to the promotion of Mobile. She's had several showings in the Mobile area. She did this rendition from a little wallet-sized photograph of Charlie that Margie was able to obtain for us. But we'd like Dorothy to have the original of this.
So, ready?